So hello everyone, I am presenting on the prevalence of radiographically confirmed knee osteoarthritis and the distribution of radiographical changes in an adult population in a suburban setting in Sri Lanka. I am Fazlia Hassan and the other authors in this study work, Professor Nalika Gunawardana, Dr. Inoshi Athukolla, Ms. Akalanka Hettiheva and Dr. Indra Lekamge. When considering the prevalence of radiographically confirmed knee osteoarthritis and the distribution of the radiographical changes within this population in the suburban setting. Our justification for this research was that we observe a high prevalence among female, among adults who have been diagnosed with knee osteoarthritis. But there have been no recent published data on the community prevalence and the radiographical changes. So this was a community-based descriptive cross-sectional study. It included a sample of 845 adults, male and female, who were about 50 years from the Pitakote MOH area. Out of this, out of the 845 adults of the population sample, 144 were referred for x-rays or radiographical changes based on the American College of Rheumatologists criteria for diagnosis of knee osteoarthritis. So after they were diagnosed according to the ACR criteria, they were referred for x-rays. Only 94 participants out of the 144 participants who were sent for x-rays, only 94 participants had taken anteroposterior and lateral x-rays. So out of these findings, based on the ACR criteria and out of the population who was sent for x-rays, out of the 94 participants, there was a 9.3 prevalence of radiologically confirmed knee osteoarthritis. So after they were diagnosed with the ACR criteria, with the radiological confirmation, there was a 9.3 prevalence among the whole population. 3.9% prevalence was seen in males and 10.8% was seen among females. The radiographic changes that were seen present in 79 of the sample, for both knees, it was 76 only for the left one and 2 for the right. So majority were in grade 3 of the KLN grade for knee OA, and majority had little narrowing of joint space in both knees. Osteophytes were present in 83% and 65 participants had it in both knees. So this tendon ossification was also seen, osteopenia, joint subluxation. These were the radiographical changes seen in the x-rays of this population. So the graph is showing the presence of radiographic changes in 9.3% of the sample. These are our conclusions that we derived from the study. Thank you.